right, welcome back to the show, folks. We are here with Aviana Cerezo, who is the co-chair for the Healthy San Bernardino Coalition. Welcome to the show, Aviana.
Hi.
So I see you brought some product with you here, or some produce, excuse me. I have to use my fancy language now. I see you brought some produce with you. So why don't you tell me a little bit about your responsibilities as the co-chair for the Healthy San Bernardino Coalition.
Definitely, and thank you so much for having me here today. And so the Healthy San Bernardino Coalition started in 2010, and it was a response to a scan that we did of the community to look at our health indicators. And so those indicators really showed us that we need a lot of work to do with having access to healthy foods. Mm-hmm. And so one of the programs that we offer is our Farm Share program. And it's a 13-week cycle, and there's four different seasons in the year. And people come to City Hall on Thursdays from 11:30 to 1:30, and they pick up their fresh and local produce every week, and they can come during their lunch break, and it encourages them to be more active mm-hmm. and get out from their desk and stretch out their legs a little bit.
Very cool. And so how many citizens participate in this program every, 14 weeks?
Yeah, definitely. So right now we have, 34 participating families.
Excellent.
And so they can sign up for either a half share or a full share, depending on how many people were in the mm-hmm. house and how much produce they use. I mean, I'm a family of one, and I get a full share. Mm-hmm. And this is what you would see in a typical full share. There's five different types of fruits, five different types of veggies, and an herb. And this week we have our dill. And as you can see, it is a big bushel. And it is.
And it smells amazing.
It
does,
so
yes.
good.
And everything here is so colorful, which mm-hmm. I think most people know. You need a colorful plate, which is very cool.
Yeah, I like that. And so what started this initiative here in the city?
And so this is one of the initiatives that came out from the mayor's office, so Mayor Patrick Morris. And so they were really trying to capture and see what they needed to improve on for health. And so it showed that we have a really high retail food environmental index, and so that shows how many unhealthy to healthy options that you have. Mm-hmm. And so the one for the state is 4-1, which kind of sounds bad, right?
Yeah.
And the one for the city is 9-1, so we're more than double,
meaning we have 9 unhealthy options to 1 healthy option.
That is correct.
Yeah. And then how many residents of the city are considered obese?
We have about 40%.
40%, wow. Mm-hmm.
And it's actually in line with also our poverty rate, which is also at about 40% at mm-hmm. or, above the federal poverty guideline level. And there's a nexus between the amount of poverty in your community to the amount of obesity
right.
and health-related challenges.
So that can be very intimidating to see those numbers. And how do you start to conquer that?
Definitely. And so we try to do a lot of grassroots outreach, and we are able to do a lot of these programs mm-hmm. through collaboration. That's why it's called the Healthy San Bernardino Coalition.
Right.
It's all with our partnership with our partners. And so we've coined this idea as called Health Hubs.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's just a place where lots of activities around health are occurring. And so we've started a Striders walking program.
Mm-hmm.
And this can be open to any of the residents, and so they're typically at one of our community centers. So Spiker Park is a perfect example of a health hub. Mm-hmm. So we have a community garden there, and we have a walking club, and they have activities that are already going on there at the center. So they have workshops and nutrition classes. We can teach them all about kale and how to make delicious smoothies. Mm-hmm. Someone was telling me that they can do an avocado shake. So
yeah.
These are the types of things, and we're utilizing these health hubs not only to offer everyday health tips, but also to build that community and bring that trust back again and getting our community residents more engaged.
Definitely.
Excellent.
Being more engaged. And how would a citizen get involved with the community garden? I understand in different communities that have them, sometimes there can be a wait list and mm-hmm. it can take time to get involved.
Definitely. So they can come to City Hall, come mm-hmm. up to the 6th floor, or they can reach us at the office. And then we also have a Facebook group page, but it's It's more targeted towards our farm share program, and that's, you can just Google downtown San Bernardino farm share market, and we have all sorts of ways that people can get involved. They can start attending the monthly coalition meetings, which is the third Thursday of every month, or they can just go into their local community center and ask them, you know, how can I get plugged into a health hub? How can I get into a community garden? And so that's kind of how we've started these initiatives. People have asked us, you know, we want a walking club. So that's how the Striders program came to fruition, is because that's what the residents wanted. That's what they asked us for.
You know, so this is a great variety of produce. I mean, you have a lot of different things. Where do all these fruits and vegetables come from?
And that is a great question. Part of the farm share is an opportunity to make local farming and small farm owners more sustainable. And so what you see here is the collaboration of 30 local farmers. And so we have farmers there from Fallbrook, which seems kind of far, but they're able to grow things that we can't grow here in, say, Riverside or Redlands, in Mentone. And one of the items that I want to point to are the oranges. And so there's a lot of history with oranges here in our region, but a lot of these farmers are being challenged by corporate farming, global competition, and so they're being driven out from their farms. And so these farm share programs are a great way to stimulate the local economy and to work on job development. And they're also being threatened. There's this Asian citrus bacteria that's going around, and so the oranges are going to be decimated. So farmers are turning and finding a way to think outside the orange pill to grow different options so they can still sustain their business and sustain their livelihoods.
That is great. Wow. Well, that's new information for us here.
Really good information to know, and to also not only, you know, be aware of where we can go to these local communities and City Hall, but also how can we get involved to help to drive this communication so more people can know. Where's the contact information that we can go to for that?
Definitely. The best contact would be to call 909-384-5133, and that's the mayor's office, and they can ask for myself, Aviana, and they can also check out our Facebook group page for the Farm Share Market. And like I said, we have our monthly coalition meetings the third Thursday of every month, and we're open to not only nonprofits and small businesses, but also to our community members. And their voice is one of the most important ones and the ones that matter. So yeah, they can just go to a community center, and part of our motto with our Striders Walking Club is making strides for changing lives. And that is what we are there to do.
Thank you so much, Aviana, for being with us today. And thank you for being here as well. Until next time, thank you so much.